came down from Dana after the Benson Gilbert fight that you, the winner of Gray, and you would be getting the fight. I think that took a lot of people by surprise. How would you, you know, would you agree with that? Or
I do agree with it.
Were you surprised?
To say I wasn't surprised would be lying. I feel like you know where he's at in the division and where I'm trying to get to, and you know, a win over Gray, and I feel like definitely would solidify a title shot. You know, but again, it's never up to me, and the decision's not mine. But you know, I feel like, you know, I am deserving, and you know, that's a really big thing for me, is, you know, believing in it, and you know, just feeling like I earned this.
When the word came down, did you feel like an influx of pressure? Did you feel like, oh man,
no,
now I can,
no,
actually, my whole view's been on this title, and now,
you know what? That is the long term view, is the title.
Right.
But at the time I'm sitting here, I was training to fight Gray Maynard, and you know, I knew what a win would do for me, and you know,
right,
for my career. So I was treating it like that to begin with. I was incredibly motivated and focused, and just ready to get out there and fight him. And this, I mean, there's always pressure for a fight, so I don't feel like it's going to be any different. I mean, the lights are the same.
But it is, though. I mean, with the title on the line, so how do you balance that?
You know,
because I mean, whether you acknowledge it in your brain that it is, or it's, you know what I mean, it still is different. It's much different than any other fight you've ever had.
It is, but I also feel like I haven't felt any different pressure from it because of it. I feel like, you know, the work's done. I put it in. I work my butt off every day to be, you know, at my best for this fight. And, you know, when I get out there, it's usually never an issue to shut everything off and go fight, you know, and that's what I plan to do. I feel like every day I just kept working. Like, that was it. And, you know, I got a good team, and my coach, Scott McClain, is always, you know, pushing me to get better. And you know, you got to have somebody that's always trying to make you improve and get better. If you're not getting better, you're getting worse. And the second you think you're the best, you're done. So I'm always trying to get better. And you know, I put in the work. I definitely believe in myself 100%. And when I get out there, I feel like I can beat anyone.
Do you think that part of that is the importance of keeping a smaller camp or a hometown camp? Because I think a lot of the guys, you know what I mean, they get out in the world, and they think that a camp is going to get them wins. Whereas you seem kind of like a very self-confident dude, and, you know, why change what's been working for me for so long?
You know, super camps are good. I don't know. I mean,
you're like, they're good, but I wouldn't.
I've trained with some very, very high level people, and I just like what our system. You know, you don't need 30 guys in the room to spar with. You really only need like three, and you need them in good shape, and that's the key. And you need three high level guys, and you know, that's kind of where I'm at. And you know, we have a great team at Fit Plus, and you know, I'm just I'm excited, man. I'm excited to get out there and just show what I can do.
I think a lot of people think you and Gray are very similar. That said, how do you outgrind the grinder?
You know what? There's going to be a lot of little battles going on in there. He's got that great wrestling. He's got that knockout power. He's got solid striking. I mean, he's got that pressure that he puts on fighters. So, you know, I got my work cut out for me to sit there and say that, you know, I'm just going to do this and this. No, it's going to be a whole bunch of different things that I have to do. And just be in there, believe in myself, be confident, and be first.